Radiant Wonderings. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and stay a while. Today I'm continuing on with my Montana Living Moving to Montana guide. We're talking about moving to Flathead County, Montana, and today we are talking about Kalispell, Montana, the most populated city within Flathead County. So pull up a chair and let's get into it. And again, as usual, as I go through these, if I go too fast or you need some information for later, just look in the description below and I have a link to my blog post with all of this information and any links that I mentioned throughout the video. Kalispell, Montana surpassed 25,000 residents in 2020. It boasts beautiful hiking trails, cross-country skiing trails, mountain biking trails, an outdoor archery range, an equestrian schooling park, beautiful lakes and beaches, shopping, dining, fishing, the Hockaday Museum of Art, Glacier Symphony, the Conrad Museum, and more. In the City Moving Guide, I'm going to address various areas: housing, schools, recreation, amenities, pros and cons of choosing Kalispell over a different city in Flathead County. So the city of Kalispell is kind of broken up into five different areas. Technically seven, but I'm only going to do five in this one. We'll get into the other two later. So you have the West Valley area, Northern Kalispell, Downtown Kalispell, Southern Kalispell, and Evergreen. So let's get into these different areas. The other two that I mentioned that will be in different city guides are Lower Valley. I'm going to pair that one with Lakeside and Summers because it is pretty far out. And then also Creston is going to be paired with Big Fork because it's further out of the city as well. All right, so West Valley area is, as indicated, on the west side of Kalispell. It's situated at the base of the Ashley Mountain Range. It offers more of a country feel with views looking east toward the Swan Mountain Range, and also to the north you see the Whitefish Mountain Range. So it's a beautiful area to live. The area is easily accessible by the Highway 93 bypass that was recently completed, and students here attend West Valley School. It's a kindergarten through eighth grade establishment before attending Glacier High School. Northern Kalispell is found to the north of Highway 2 along Highway 93. If you want to be in the midst of all the action, this is the place to be. This is where you will find the big box stores like Costco, Target, Walmart, TJ Maxx, and more. You'll also find the movie theater here, many restaurants, and Glacier High School. I often find myself here several times a week just for shopping and dining. Students in Northern Kalispell will attend Kalispell Middle School before moving on to Glacier High School. The area of Evergreen is found where Highway 2 veers north from downtown and continues on up just past Reserve Drive. Students here attend Evergreen Junior High School before moving on to Glacier High School. Evergreen has some shopping. They have a Family Dollar, a Goodwill, a Joann Fabrics, but they have been susceptible to some of the stores like Kmart and Shopko going out of business as residents flock to Northern Kalispell. Downtown Kalispell boasts a nicely kept main street with beautiful old street lamps displaying flower baskets in the summer and evergreens with lights in the winter, along with parades and shopping and dining events monthly, restaurants, salons, various shops, coffee bistros, and more. The courthouse is a stately building situated along Main Street where the road divides before coming back together and heading into Southern Kalispell. Downtown Kalispell is along 93, a little bit to the north, but mostly to the south of Highway 2, where you can find beautiful historic homes throughout all of downtown. But they will be smattered with some smaller rundown cottages needing a little love and care. Downtown Kalispell residents will attend Kalispell Middle School before moving on to either Flathead High School or Glacier High School. To the south of Highway 2 goes to Flathead High School, to the north of Highway 2 will go to Glacier High School. Southern Kalispell is located along Highway 93, south of Kalispell, and Highway 93 alternate until the two roads meet. Southern Kalispell has a grocery store, a health food store, fast food options, and Kalispell City Airport, which is not to be confused with Glacier Park International Airport. Kalispell City Airport is a smaller, more private airport, not for public commercial airline flights. Students in Southern Kalispell will attend Kalispell Middle School before moving on to Flathead High School. Okay, so what about those home prices in Kalispell, Montana? The median price for a home in Kalispell is just over $323,000. And that simply means that half of the houses that are listed are higher than that, and half of the houses that are listed in Kalispell, Montana fall below that. So again, as I went through the various areas of Kalispell, Montana, some of your more affordable housing will be in Evergreen and Southern Kalispell, and some of your pricier options will probably be in Northern Kalispell, Eastern Downtown, but you can find a smattering of price points all throughout. And the commute time for Kalispell is just over 15 minutes. The national average is 26 minutes, just over, so that's pretty nice. There really isn't a ton of traffic here on Reserve Drive. They've labeled it a state of emergency because it does get backed up there. However, other than that, you're mostly on roads going quite fast, 45 to 70 miles per hour to get where you're going here. And public transportation. Okay, we're not known for great public transportation here in Montana. However, we do have some, so that is a plus. All of the vehicles are ADA accessible and provided with lifts. Most of their routes go through downtown Kalispell and then a bit into southern Kalispell and northern Kalispell. There is also a commuter line that will go between Kalispell, Whitefish, and Columbia Falls. And most fares are just a dollar each way, so it's a budget-friendly option. All right, you guys, let's move on to schools before heading into recreation. West Valley School, as I said, is a kindergarten through eighth grade establishment. The school is a smaller school. The kids, because it's elementary plus middle school, the kids in middle school here stay younger a little bit longer, so that's a little bit nice. My daughters both went here. They loved the family feel. They loved the teachers here. It just really felt like a cozy home for them. However, if your student is very into sports, this may not be the best school for them. West Valley, they excel here and there at sports, but they in general are not as good in the sports arena as Kalispell Middle School or Evergreen Junior High School. They do pretty well on their cross-country team though. The rating for West Valley Middle School is 7 out of 10. Now moving on to Evergreen Junior High School, their rating is a 6 out of 10. They have quite a few athletic opportunities and extracurricular activities. Football, basketball, volleyball, drama, a gifted and talented program, and student leadership opportunities. And that website where I'm pulling these school ratings and some of that information is greatschools.org, and I will link that in the blog post below as well. Kalispell Middle School has an 8 out of 10 rating, and it is the largest middle school in all of Flathead County with over 1,000 students. This school offers the most electives for middle schoolers in the Valley. Elective offerings currently include multiple art and language options, sewing, culinary, and gardening options, woodworking. I've seen some beautiful things come out of the woodworking class there, creative construction, engineering, and intro to computer science. They also put on a play every spring, so if your children are into acting, it gives a great opportunity for them to use those skills as well. Flathead High School is a 9th through 12th establishment with a 5 out of 10 rating, and again, any students that are south of Highway 2 in Kalispell will attend Flathead High School. The high school offers various activities from band, orchestra, National Honor Society, speech and debate, theater, and Business Professionals of America. They also offer a variety of athletic opportunities and enjoy a cross-town football rivalry with Glacier High School. Glacier High School is a 9th through 12th grade establishment as well, with a 7 out of 10 rating. Students that live north of Highway 2 will attend Glacier High School. The school also has a VOAG program, a vocational agriculture program, which is pretty cool. And they offer AP courses and the ability to take college courses during your junior and senior year. All right, and as far as Kalispell churches go, there are plenty to choose from. There are three main players here in Kalispell. East Haven Baptist Church, they have an amazing youth group, very vibrant. My daughters go here sometimes, even though we don't attend this church, just because their friends go here and they love it. They also have an Awana program, which is really nice for the littles. And really nice for the parents of littles because it kind of gives them a date night every Wednesday evening while their children are learning scripture and having fun at church. Canvas Church is another big one. They have campuses in Kalispell, Columbia Falls, and Cutbank, Montana. And they are known here for their pastor's very friendly and personable and just will come up and greet you by name. And then Fresh Life has a campus in Kalispell and a campus in Whitefish, along with campuses all over the state of Montana and into Salt Lake City and Portland, Oregon. This church is vibrant and lively. They do a lot of service projects in the community, but you may not get that personable feel here as much as you would some other places. And then additionally, there are so many other smaller churches smattered about Kalispell. Seventh-day Adventist, Jehovah's Witness, Lutheran, Catholic. So there are plenty of options to choose from here. And one more quick thing to cover before moving on to recreation is taxes. Kalispell, Montana does not have any sales tax, which is really nice for those larger purchases like vehicles, sporting goods equipment, that sort of thing. But any purchase as well, it adds up. So it's a nice perk of the area. I'm not sure about property taxes here. I believe throughout all of Flathead County, property taxes are fairly equal. And I believe that's around 1% of your property value. Aside from Whitefish, Montana, I'm pretty sure those are a bit higher. However, I'm still waiting to hear back from the county treasurer on that. So if that's really important to you, click the link below for my blog, and as soon as I get that information, I will post it in there. Okay, so we're gonna move on to recreation, the fun part. So for any of these city guides, I cannot possibly cover all of the recreation. So I'm going to cover some of the most well-known areas, but there are plenty of other opportunities throughout each of these cities for recreation. So let's start with Lone Pine State Park. Lone Pine State Park boasts over 7 miles of trails. They have a visitor center with educational opportunities. You can hike here, you can snowshoe here, you can bike here. They welcome horse and rider, and they also have the outdoor archery range, which is a lot of fun. Lone Pine State Park also has a lookout boasting beautiful views over Kalispell and out to Flathead Lake, the Swan Mountain Range, Whitefish Mountain, and Glacier National Park. Heron Park is just next door to Lone Pine State Park, and they host several horse shows a year. You can find out more about that at heronparkec.org. I'll put that link in the blog post below as well. But you can also do hiking here and biking and snowshoeing. And when you hike to the top of Heron Park, there are beautiful views over Foy's Lake. It's like a crystal blue lake. And then you see the mountains in the backdrop. It's really, really nice. And that brings us to Foy's Lake. Residents here visit Foy's Lake for fishing and boating, paddleboarding, kayaking, swimming. It's a beautiful lake, and it's stocked annually with rainbow trout. Woodland Park is in downtown Kalispell. It's open year-round in the winter. They have an outdoor skating rink. They have a park play area, and then in the summer, Woodland Water Park is a lot of fun for the kids. They have a lazy river, a lap pool. They have two water slides, and they offer private and group swim lessons. They're typically open from June to August. And then there's the Conrad Mansion. It's on the National Register of Historic Places. It was the former home of Charles Conrad, who had started a successful shipping and freighting company in the late 1800s. It boasts over 13,000 square foot of living space spread out amongst 26 rooms with 8 fireplaces. It's a beautiful home to tour, and the grounds are lovely as well. You can actually rent out the grounds here for events, weddings, birthday parties, reunions, and more. Guided tours are available for a cost, but do require 24 hours notice. The Hockaday Museum of Art features a Crown of the Continent Glacier National Park collection year-round, and then they also rotate various collections and works of art from nationally acclaimed artists, and then some of those newer to the scene as well. They offer children's art classes, adult workshops, and a senior tour in tea once a month. Glacier Symphony offers a masterwork season of subscription concerts. They offer educational programming for area schools, and my personal favorite is a family-friendly outdoor symphony night hosted at Rebecca Farm. It's a beautiful event. You just bring your wine or your picnic and sit and enjoy the lovely orchestra music. They also host the region's only week-long classical music series. And speaking of Rebecca Farm, every summer, Rebecca Farm hosts one of the largest equine competitions in all of North America. Brings over 600 to 700 horses and riders, over 1,000 spectators, a shopping fair, and more. It is a fun event to see. And in the winter months, they host a ski joring competition offering over 10,000 in prizes. And then Kalispell, Montana also has the Pig Farm Trail System. I know that's a weird name, but it was located next to a pig farm. So we're very creative here. It's Pig Farm Trails. Anyways, it's about 91 trails, over 44 miles, mountain biking trails, horse trails. I would not recommend going here if you move to the area without a local. The trails are not well marked. they're not marked at all, really. So you can easily get lost here. But if you go with a local, they show you around. It is a really fun area to go. There's no cost to go here. Just grab your mountain bike and head on out and have a good time. Do remember your bear spray. I will link to my tutorial on how to use bear spray as well below. All right, you guys, let's move on to shopping and dining before I get into the pros and cons of Kalispell and close this video out for the week. So for shopping and dining, let's begin in downtown Kalispell. Downtown Kalispell offers a plethora of shopping and dining options. Brick's Bottle Shop carries over 300 rotating craft beers along with fine wines, gourmet foods, and gifts. The toggery and Montana scene are sure to get you outfitted with clothes for the new season. Downtown has several florist shops, multiple coffee shops, unique to Montana gift shops, and there's plenty more down there. If all that shopping makes you hungry, there are so many restaurants down there, some of our favorites, and I will probably feature these in a Kalispell, Montana Eat Stay Shop Play edition, so stay tuned for that. But Norm's Soda Fountain is such a fun place to go. Moose's Saloon is just a unique experience. You either love it or hate it there. Blue Samurai has sushi downtown, and I love sushi, so they have one of my favorite rolls in the valley. DeSoto Grill for your pulled pork barbecue and mac and cheese and just good homestyle cooking. Hops, Scotty Belly's, Kalispell Brewing Company, Sweet Peaks Ice Cream with a nice little rooftop patio looking out over the city, and there are many, many more. Downtown Kalispell also has the Kalispell Center Mall. I don't get your hopes up here. There's not a lot that it has in it, but the mall is there and it is within walking distance right along Main Street and close to Highway 2. And moving up to Northern Kalispell, like I said, residents are known to find them here often. Well, you have Lowe's, Home Depot, the theater, you have Target, Walmart, TJ Maxx, Home Goods. I'm told we're getting an Old Navy suit and maybe a Barnes & Noble. Oh yeah, and sporting goods and hunting stores. You have Cabela's, Sportsman Ski House, REI, craft stores. You have Michael's and Hobby Lobby here. Then as far as food is concerned, one of our favorites in Northern Kalispell is Mackenzie River Pizza Company. Also, Brass Tap is a great place to go and sit outside and have a beer or sangria. Famous Dave's Barbecue, Applebee's, Chick-fil-A, Panera Bread, Jimmy John's, Firehouse Subs, Cold Stone Creamery, Qdoba, Costa Vida. I could go on and on. So there is a plethora of shopping and dining options in Northern Kalispell as well. And moving on to Evergreen, like I said, they don't have a lot, but they do offer some things. Smart Food Service just came into Evergreen. They're kind of like a Costco, but they don't require a membership. They also have a Family Dollar, Joann Fabrics, Goodwill. They have a lot of home stores like carpet, tile, granite, lighting, that sort of thing. As far as food is concerned, they have some fast food options. Little Caesars, Burger King, a Mexican restaurant, Charlie Wong's, Perkins. And then the other areas, Southern Kalispell, they do have a Mexican restaurant. And then some fast food options, Frugal's Drive-Thru. They have really good burgers and fries and cheese curds. West Valley really doesn't have anything. So if you're in West Valley, you're gonna head to downtown or Northern Kalispell for your shopping and dining needs. Okay, so what are the pros and cons to choosing Kalispell over another city in Flathead County? So let's start with the pros. As the most populated city in Flathead County, you have access to the most shopping and dining, to the theater, to the airport. Everything is right there within easy reach. Median home prices here are some of the lowest in the county, so that helps you out a lot. And public high schools are at or above the state average. Kalispell has plenty of recreational opportunities as well. And it's nice because it's centrally located between the other cities. So you can enjoy everything that they have to offer as well within a short drive. The commute times for those cities are as follows. From Kalispell to Whitefish Mountain Ski Resort to the actual lodge is 36 minutes. From Kalispell to the west entrance of Glacier National Park, your commute time is going to be 46 minutes. Now, this is just from the center. All of these are just from the center of Kalispell, so it could be a little more or a little less depending on where in Kalispell you're located. From Kalispell to Blacktail Mountain Ski Area, that one is in Lakeside, it's 49 minutes. That one's a little bit longer because Blacktail Mountain Ski Resort is interesting in that the lodge and where you start is at the top of the mountain. So You take a run down before you ever take a ski lift ride back up. And then your commute time to Big Fork, Lakeside, and Whitefish, just the cities, is 20-25 minutes. That's it. So you can enjoy everything they have to offer as well. Okay, so what are some of the cons of choosing Kalispell? As the most populated city in Flathead County, it loses a little bit of that small town feel and the walkability that comes with that. Certainly, if you are in downtown Kalispell, you can walk to a lot of places. But other than that, you're going to need a vehicle or you need to find yourself along the public transportation routes. And while it's centrally located in the valley, which is nice, it is further away from some of those main attractions like Whitefish Mountain Ski Resort. Obviously, if you live in Whitefish, you're closer to that. Or the West Glacier entrance, obviously, if you live in Columbia Falls or West Glacier, you're going to be closer to that. Big Fork and Lakeside, they're more summer destinations. They're right along Flathead Lake, so they have that benefit. Also, Blacktail Ski Mountain Resort, if you're in Lakeside, you're going to be closer to that. So you are a little bit further out from some of the recreation. However, you're central, so you can get to all of it within less than an hour, which is really nice. All right, you guys, I think that covers it for Kalispell, Montana. If I missed anything, leave a comment below and let everybody know. As I get comments of things that I possibly missed, I will update the blog post, so be sure to click on that and see if there's anything new added. Also, hit that notification bell so you're notified when the next city guide drops. And I hope you guys have an awesome week. I'll see you around.